Are you a person that see this glass as half empty or half full? Let's see together two different perspectives that can change completely your life, and I'm going to use only practical examples. So let's say that, for example, you are a coach, a therapist, an entrepreneur, and you have just created your new product and you want to launch it. If you see things from the half empty perspective, most probably you are going to try to preserve yourself from a launch, for example, that might not work. What I mean is that there is a possibility that you are going to launch your product with a kind of back thought, like, no, it's okay. If it doesn't work, well, at least I didn't risk so much. Or you start launching thinking already that most probably is not going to work. And that means also that you are start to launch thinking things like, most probably this price is too high for the most of the people. Or maybe that you are too late respect to the date where you decide to launch it. Let's say it's Christmas time and you think you do not have enough time to make a proper launch. And therefore, this is going to explain at the end why your launch it didn't work. Or simply you make a launch, but you just think like, let's see how it goes. You see? If instead you have the full half perspective, most probably what you're going to think is, first, your product is so good that is impossible that people are not going to like it. And then that most probably most people are crashing to go to buy it. And therefore, I would say no matter which will be the price, they're going to be happy to pay that price. And then there will be things, doesn't matter if I only launch it for 10 days, my product is so good that will be more than enough to make a really successful launch. Can you see the difference? Are the same people. The product is exactly the same, but one is thinking that, I'm not sure it's going to work and I have to preserve myself from eventually fail, and the other one is just completely thinking that the product is so good that there is no reason to think that the launch is not going to work. It's going to work, no matter what. Let's say another example, you are a student and tomorrow you have an exam. Perfect. So you want to see it from, let's say, the negative perspective, the half empty glass point of view. I'm, let's say, that a student and I'm going to think, oh my God, I didn't have the time to repeat chapter 12, 14, 21. So I'm going to sleep with this idea that I review everything for tomorrow except for those three chapters. And I'm going to get stress and stress and stress, and thinking that most probably I'm going to get questions that are in those chapters that I didn't review. So what is going to happen most probably is that I'm not going to sleep very well. I'm going to wake up super stressed. I'm going to arrive to the test with the exam or whatever, tired, or anyway with low energy. And I have two possibilities. So the exam start, and if I got the question around the chapter that I've not reviewed, I'm so in panic, most probably, that I will not be able to write or to answer to anything. Or it might be that I do not get the question around those chapter, so I get question around all the other chapter I review, but I'm so stressed, so tired, so low energy that most probably I'm not going to perform as much I could if I was feeling super positive. So let's say that now I am the same person that didn't review the same number of chapter, but I have a perspective that is the full half glass. That means that I'm going to think something like, okay, I did all the other chapter. It has to be really something crazy if I fall down on question only on those three chapter, the 12, the 14 and the 21. So I'm not going to stress out for those three chapter. And maybe I'm going to sleep, relax, I'm going to wake up. Well, I can't say probably relax because anyway, I have an important exam in front of me, but probably I'm going to have a completely different energy of the other type of student. I will be also more relaxed, more confident. Therefore, I have again the two possibilities. I'm an exam, I got the question around exactly the chapter I didn't review. So, as I'm anyway quite confident, anyway quite relaxed, but most of all I sleep, I have less stress, or I arrive here with less stress, there is a possibility I can put something together, that I can remember something, because anyway I didn't review, but doesn't mean that I didn't read anything at all, and maybe I can make something. Or I have the possibility that I do not get the question about the chapter that I didn't review. I got the question on all the other chapter, and as I'm already in such a good mood, or anyway I'm less stressed than the other person, I'm going to answer or to write the answer, I don't know which will be the exam, but in a huge positive way, so my performance might be at the best. So can you see the difference? Same person, same type of study, same level of knowledge, let's say, but one is absolutely focused on what can go wrong and the other one is absolutely focused on what has been done positive and what can be the positive result. Let's see, instead, if you are, let's say, a different person, if you are an highly sensitive person, it means that most probably for the most of the time during your life, you have heard sentence like, oh, you are too so sensitive, you are so emotional, oh, you think so much. Okay, again, you have two different ways to say things. The negative is, I'm so sick of this. I'm tired to feel always so much judged. I'm tired to feel completely different from the other. I'm tired that no one can understand me. I'm tired to feel, fragile. I'm tired to feel that I'm not enough. And so on. To a point where I do not feel good enough and I live my life really a kind of low level because I do not give myself all the possibility to live the life that I want. And then we have the same person that see things from a positive perspective. That means, yes, of course, this person has always heard things like, you are too sensitive, you think too much, you are too emotional, blah, blah, blah. But that person can just absolutely accept that the most of the people are not like me. Let's say I'm that person. Most of the people are not like me, so how is possible they can really understand me? They have no clue of what I feel, what I can see, what I can hear, and they can't understand neither how much I can help, support people around me, and the joy I can give, the support I can give, and I decide or I want to make the best of this sensitivity and to see it more as a gift instead of a problem. So I give you different examples in different situations. It might be also the manager that wants to get the promotion. The point is also there. Are you thinking in a positive way in the sense that anyway, let's say by the end of the year, you are going to have your promotion. Therefore, if you are so positive about getting the promotion, are you most probably working in a way like you already got that promotion? You are thinking in a way like you already are that person that got the promotion. You are most probably acting, talking, as you already got that promotion. And so you have much deeper possibility to get that promotion. If instead you see things from a negative point of view, and you are again the same type of manager that wants to have that promotion by the end of the year, if you focus always on double checking what the other got, what the other are doing, what the other are thinking, most probably you are going to think that maybe you're not good enough. Oh, by the way, for sure that person is going to get this promotion before me, or there will be for sure things that makes that I will not get that promotion. Maybe there will be the virus, maybe it will be the company that meets the budget. Whatever excuse you want, you are going to act, talk, live as you know you can't have at the end of the day that promotion. With this video, I want to show you, and in those examples too, that you might, of course, you might want to control things. You might want to prevent as much as possible your fear, anxiety, situation where you might not feel comfortable. But that actually the only thing you can really, really control are your thoughts. You can decide if see things from a positive perspective or from a negative perspective. And depending which perspective you are choosing, you are getting a completely different reality. What I mean is that every single minute you decide what are your thoughts, and therefore from your thought you will get your emotion, you will get your action, you will get your behavior, and therefore you will get your reality. So the only thing you can control are your thoughts. Therefore, be conscious of what are you thinking. And again, if you decide which are your thoughts, you decide which is your reality. That means that even right now, if you do not like your reality, you can change it. Is it wonderful, isn't it? Thanks for watching, and put a like if you enjoyed this video, if it was useful, or if you want to let me know what did you think, or what are other subjects that you want me to develop, write down a comment.